In the U.S. intersection, on the right is Hector Becerra, Laura Pollán, the lady in the center is Berta Soraya, the leader of the Dallas Obando, and on the left is Laura Maria Laura Pollán, Larissa, who is the daughter of Laura Pollán, and I'm going to read the statement by her, which we'll hear from the others later. But in the beginning, let me read, we have two important statements from the Obama administration, which I think show the importance that is attached to what we're doing today and the issue of freedom in Cuba. The first is from President Obama. Let me read it. Today, as the National Endowment for Democracy awards the Democracy Service Medal posthumously to Laura Pollán, the founder of Damas de Blanco, we honor and celebrate her life by recognizing her significant contributions to the struggle to defend human rights in Cuba. Laura Pollán and the quiet dignity of the ladies in white have courageously voiced the core desire of the Cuban people and of people everywhere to live in liberty, taking to the streets in peaceful protest to draw attention to the plight of those unjustly held in Cuba's prisons. Laura Pollán and the ladies in white have stood bravely against Cuban authorities who limit laws and resort to house arrest and temporary detention in a failed attempt to silence them. Through Laura Pollán has accomplished the Blanco's brave actions. The world bore witness to the repressive actions of Cuban authorities, eventually leading to the release of political prisoners wrongly jailed in the spring of 2003. Though Laura is not with us today, her bravery in the face of repression and her selfless commitment to democracy and human rights in Cuba offer a living legacy that inspires us to keep moving forward. To Matanas de Blanco, who will watch or listen to today's ceremony, you have our utmost respect for your efforts to stand up for the rights of the Cuban people, even in the face of this weekend's crackdown directed at you, and we honor each of you as well. The United States is steadfast in supporting the simple desire of the Cuban people to freely determine their future and to enjoy the rights and freedoms that define the Americans, and that should be universal to all human beings. I remain committed to supporting civil society in Cuba, including by protecting the ability of Cuban Americans to support their families in Cuba through unrestricted family business and remittances. That's a message from President Obama.